Good morning, YouTubers. Thank you for joining me today. Today's video is going to be a quick, I guess we will call it an introduction to this new addition to my collection. This is the Seal Instruments D42T Diver's Watch. You've seen Seal make an appearance on my channel before with their Omnidiver, which is this one. Today's video is just going to be a quick introduction. I'm going to tell you a little bit about the specs, the size, what I love about this watch. And then when I have a little bit more time, I'm going to do a quick comparison of this watch with my other Seal, particularly for those viewers who are interested in trying to pick which of these two watches they may be interested in buying from Seal Instruments. So with that, let me kind of just talk to you briefly about the specs of this watch. If you're a first-time viewer to my channel, you may have never seen a Seal watch before. These watches are very unique. They're made in very, very limited production. They're manufactured in Tucson, Arizona by Seal Instruments, which is like a one or a two-man shop there who they machine and manufacture all of the components of this watch in-house in a machine shop in Arizona. They use super high-quality Swiss-made movements. Even the luminous material is made in-house, and the screws and the components are all made in-house by the owner of the company, the designer and the engineer behind this. These watches are really, really special if you're interested in super high-end dive watches, if the technology really fascinates you, and if you like titanium watches, these, in my opinion, are pretty much the best that you can get at any price point anywhere. So let me do this. You know, normally when I do a quick introduction, I like to sort of measure the watch myself, but I've discovered that perhaps because by the very nature of the fact that these watches are created by an engineer, the specs on the websites for the brand are exacting. So what I'm going to do, I'll just read you the specs from the website. So the D42T, it's the case diameter, this part of the case, the diameter is 41.9 millimeters in diameter. So this is a sort of a traditionally sized watch at basically 42 millimeters across this way. And the bezel, as you can see, is slightly bigger. The bezel diameter is 43.2. So this really does wear like a 42. Because it's titanium, it's lightweight, it wears light. The height of the case is 12.9 millimeters thick. In this direction, you can see it has like a broad, flat case back, no sharp edges. It has a flat crystal. The crystal's just ever so slightly recessed under the bezel. And the bezel has a very, very, very subtle domed action. Sort of, if you can see, sort of this is sort of slightly domed. I don't think you can tell from my camera. But it really helps it tuck under a shirt well. And at sub 13 millimeters is very thin. I mean, the reality is this watch would, you could wear it under even a tight shirt cuff, even French cuffs. The lug to lug is 48.3 millimeters. So from here to here, these have strap adapters. Normally, it's an option. You can buy this watch with strap adapters and wear it like on a NATO, like I've been wearing it the last couple of days, or on a bracelet. The bracelet looks like this. The bracelets are sort of in production right now, so I ordered the bracelet. I just don't, it's not been delivered yet. I'm waiting for that to be built. But since they're all made by an individual, all the parts, the screws, everything is made by the same person, you know, I had to wait for the bracelet. The weight of this watch on the bracelet, when the bracelet gets here, would only be 135 grams. That's fairly light. That means it weighs about the same as maybe a no-date sub, perhaps. See, with this bracelet, maybe a little bit more than a no-date sub. I only use that because that's a watch so many people are familiar with. But it means it weighs less than, you know, an all-steel dive watch of the same, similar size. On a NATO strap, I think it weighs about 90 grams. So on this ADAPT strap, it weighs about 90 grams. So like when you take it off, you do this, you can feel that it has a certain level of density, a certain mass, but it's very lightweight. It feels like a very high quality watch. It has enough weight to feel that way, but it's light. So I won't say it like flops around, but it feels very lightweight. So those are the specs, the size. Let me tell you a little bit about the performance characteristics. So the watch is water resistant to 5,100 meters or 495 atmospheres. And let me say that again, 5,100 meters water resistance. In terms of performance, it's really remarkable. Like, there's got to be no watch this size that's this water resistant that's not, you know, oil filled, and this watch is not oil filled. This watch is just impeccably engineered to be extremely water resistant. The case, the adapters, all these parts are made of entirely of grade 5 titanium. Grade 5 titanium is 6Al 4B titanium, 6% aluminum, 4% vanadium. It's typically what is referred to as aircraft grade alloy. Very few watches are actually made of titanium alloy. Hublot makes a couple that are $20,000. Grand Seiko makes some that are many, many thousands of dollars. That's about it. Maybe a couple of Blancpains in the $10,000 to $20,000 range are made of grade 5, but most brands use grade 2. It's a softer metal, and you know, titanium has sort of this exotic nature about it, and that's actually because of titanium alloys. So for me, that's a big deal. I love that it's clearly engraved on the case back. That makes these watches special to me. I like that they're made of titanium alloy, and it's certainly part of the appeal of this watch to me as a dive watch enthusiast. The case back, the case middle, the adapters, the bezel, everything is grade 5 titanium. The crown, I believe, is 316L stainless steel. On this model, I believe the crown tube is 316L stainless steel. And the screws, I think the screws are 316L stainless steel. I think Andrew, the creator of this watch, I think he used some stainless steel parts on this newer, on these new versions, these D42s, because it's better if you have two parts that are being clamped together when you're dealing with titanium. It's better that one be stainless steel and one be titanium rather than titanium on titanium, because sort of rubbing and clamping forces when you put titanium together create galvanic reactions, which causes galling and kind of like this adhesive corrosion type effect. Even though both titanium and stainless steel are highly corrosion resistant. It has a Karopulos sapphire crystal. I'm not quite sure what Karopulos means. I just believe it's how the glass is made, but it's very, very thick. The crystal probably is roughly as thick as the bezel, perhaps. I think the bezel here is 5 millimeters. I don't think the crystal's 5 millimeters thick. Maybe it is. I think the crystal's probably like between 3 and 5 millimeters. The Big Daddy, the Omni Diver, has like a crystal that's 5 or 6 millimeters thick, but this watch is much bigger and has even a much higher level of water resistance. Couple things about this watch that I find sort of especially fascinating. So Andrew McLean, the craftsman who makes these, he makes all these parts. I've said that like 3 or 4 times, but that to me, that's a big deal. He cuts this case out of titanium alloy, and then he threads these holes in it, and he machines this case back, and then he laser engraves it, and he hand finishes these parts. He even makes these screws, and these big screws right here that hold the bracelet or whatever to the case, he makes these screws in-house. He threads these cases. Even this bezel insert, which is aluminum, was turned on a lathe from a piece of stock, and then it was hand sort of finished, and then I guess he electroplates it or some sort of anodizing, and then he laser engraves it and uses the laser engraving to take out certain bits of metal there that he fills with loom. And even the dial, if you see, there's the dial has some depth to it. I don't know, the dial has some depth to it. That's because he carved that sort of central basin out of the inside of the metal disc. And that metal disc started out as like a aluminum bar, round bar. And even the little screws between the 23 and the 12 up right up there. If you can't see. Even those little screws right there and right there, he makes these parts. I mean, even the hands are made out of, I think, some sort of a spring steel and then tempered and treated and painted, and sort of the paint is like kind of like, I think, a baked on paint, enamel. Even the little brass central posts are machined on his lathe. And many of these parts are machined by hand. I think he uses some CNC machines for some of these especially complex parts, but a lot of these parts are machined by hand. There's like something remarkable about that. And he's got a very loyal following. The people that own these watches, I think, love these watches. This is my second seal. I think he's got another model that's being cooked up in the works. He's got a few models that are being cooked up in the works. And they're all sort of essentially all like semi-custom builds. Like, I told him what I wanted and he said, sure. And I picked the hand color and I was fine with the standard bezel and the standard dial, and I wanted blue, but this yellow color is called fluorescent lime yellow, which is sort of referred to as fly, F-L-Y, and I wanted all the hands to be that color, and he said, sure, absolutely. And I wanted an HAQ because I'm really into quartz dive watches. I like quartz. Auto has its place, but I prefer quartz. Mine's number 006, the model is D42. It's just a great watch. Like, I would encourage people to look him up online. He has an Instagram. It's Seal Instruments. He's got a website, which is sealinstrument.com. That's spelled S-E-L and then instrument, like, you know, a trumpet or trombone, a musical instrument. And the brand is just really, really interesting to me. And as you can see, the watch is beautiful. I mean, if you like this look, you know, if you like this tool look, it's special. And let me show you the bezel insert. The bezel. Lines up perfectly. What else to say? Oh, you know, one of the things that makes this watch special, you can't tell unless you know, sort of, you couldn't tell this probably unless someone told you this, is that the clicking mechanism on this bezel is, it uses these spring-loaded pistons, and the top of the piston has like a sort of a tooth shape to it, and it engages this milled profile that's underneath this titanium bezel on the bottom surface of this titanium bezel. And I learned this from watching Seal Instruments Instagram feed. They show all sorts of these sort of like kind of like insider's view of the manufacturing processes for these watches. And underneath this bezel profile are these little teeth, and they engage with this spring-loaded piston, which is right here. And right here, I think maybe might even be able to see like right there in the middle of the screen, there's a little. So we're going to look right there. You'll see it. Anyway, it's a little piston and it's held in by a spring. And it creates this very, very precise, positive locking feeling. And there's no back play at all. There's just none. It's really special. I think the closest example of that feel would probably be maybe like a Rolex dive watch, like a Sub or a Sea Dweller. But these are Andrew's proprietary design. It's just really, really perfect and precise, and that makes it very, very special and very, very robust. And the bezel itself is actually held in place by, I think, 12 precision ball bearings, and they go in through that little hole, and that hole is permanently sealed unless you have it serviced by Andrew. But what happens is underneath this bezel, there's a race. And there are 12, I believe 12 little half holes drilled into it. And I think each hole is basically the half the diameter of the little ball bearing. And then what happens is you, on the inside of the bezel is a race, which is the outer surface of a ball bearing. And he drops these little balls, ball bearings, into each of those little holes. And so because there's ball bearings around this bezel that are half in the inner race and half in the outer race, the bezel is permanent, it's like impossible to separate. You wouldn't need to because it's so well designed, but it just fits together like a piece of precision equipment. It's really remarkable. And like that kind of attention to detail is all done by hand. You know, I don't think I can't think of any other watch that you can buy that has that level of hand attention to detail, you know, particularly in the engineering aspects of it. So that's one of the reasons that I just find this watch so special. All right, probably enough rambling. Let me show you what it looks like on my wrist. I put a couple of wrist shots up at the end. I want everyone to know that for all my loyal subscribers, I'm sorry I haven't posted content lately. Candidly, I didn't have a whole lot to post, but hopefully for the next few weeks, I'll post some videos showing this watch and comparing it to a few of my other watches so that you all can get a sense of perspective and a sense of size, just in case you have an interest in this watch. Let me zoom out. And know that I post new videos on Friday in the mornings, Eastern time. So there it is. Just a really beautiful watch. I love it already. Stay tuned for next week when I'll post a side-by-side with this watch. This is the full-size Omni Diver. This watch was Andrew's, I think, his first production model. Sorry, my battery's dead, but I'm going to send that off and get it replaced. Oh, by the way, Andrew, for the HAQs, one of the features is that while I don't think they have to be serviced by him, at least the newer models may not be, he replaces the batteries for free for life of the original owner. And then I'll also do a side-by-side with this Tuna, which everyone's familiar with the Tuna, but it might be good so people have a sense of size because the Tuna is a little bit more common. It gives people maybe a sense of comfort about the size of these watches. Okay, thanks for bearing with me for so long. Please like and subscribe so you'll be alerted when I post new content. Be well.